Have you considered moving to Bremen, Georgia, but you're not sure? Did the pros outweigh the cons? Watch this video because I am going to tell you all about it. I personally have a home in Bremen. I've lived there for a while. I now rent it out, but I'm a local expert on what the positives are, what the negatives are, and stay around to the end because I'm going to tell you all of the surrounding schools, how they rank, and give you a free moving checklist that will help you out if you are moving to the area. But the very first positive on our list, this is why almost everybody wants to be in Bremen, and it's because of the school system. Bremen is just known for having amazing schools. They're top five in the state of Georgia. Fox News has been out there, done several videos on them about how great their academics are. They score really well on tests. Everybody wants to be in Bremen. You have people that are looking, moving from Atlanta, moving all this way to get their kids in Bremen City School District. And it's hard to come by, but it's a really good thing that a lot of people want. They also have a really cool career path program. When you're in high school, you get to go through the career path, and then when you graduate, they have you already set up and ready to do jobs. I know I've personally worked with some of the students who were in the CNA program, and they are graduating, and they will have their CNA license. So they are ready to jump right into nursing school or whatever they want to do after high school. So it's really cool. It's a really great experience. Like I said, you ask anybody around and they'll tell you how great Bremen City Schools are and why they want to be there. Another positive, Bremen is an up-and-coming area. They have tons of growth. I remember before I bought my house, say maybe 7 years ago, there were only a few fast food chains here and there. We had the Walmart, of course, but there wasn't a whole lot of extra stuff going on. Now there's tons of new stores and restaurants popping up everywhere, and everyone is super excited because we're about to have a new Chick-fil-A. Like, it's being constructed right now. And I think you know that you have officially graduated from being really small town once you have a Chick-fil-A, right? So everyone's really excited about it. We've got a lot going on right there. We have a lot of new buildings, new stuff. It's just a really growing spot, and that's always positive. New growth also means there are new job opportunities in Bremen as well. So we have Tanner Health System. That is a hospital that's in Bremen called Higgins. Now, Tanner is actually based out of Carrollton, but they have one of their facilities in Bremen. So that's a great opportunity for lots of jobs. Obviously, your medical staff, your nurses, your CNAs, your doctors, but they also have housekeeping, managerial, secretary, dietary, all of this kinds of stuff that can employ a lot of jobs. And it's great because if you live in the Bremen area and you want to live out, you know, rurally, you still have access to a hospital really close by in case you need it. They do offer some really great benefits, but they have an on-site gym system that the employees can use, plus they offer a yearly employee appreciation event, which is really cool. We also have Walmart.com distribution center. This is a huge operation, so it employs a ton of people. Obviously, it employs the plant workers because they distribute goods to everywhere, all over America, other Walmart stores, different things like that. So you've got the housekeepers, managerial, secretaries, and they get really busy during the holiday season because of Black Friday deals and all of that stuff. So they also do temporary employees. So they not only have their full-time employees, but they also do temp jobs. So that's a really great way to really boost our economy. Now, if you do work for Walmart.com, you get a couple of really good perks. You get a Walmart discount card. You also get a discounted membership to Sam's, and they do their free yearly benefit for the employees and stuff. So it's a really great opportunity. Bremen does have a really good recreational department. So they offer good activities for the youth and adults. The complex is on River Circle in Bremen, and it has outdoor fields and an indoor gym. So they offer things like soccer, volleyball, football, basketball, and gymnastics. They also have a senior citizen center that is open daily with a walking track. So they get to hang out, get some exercise, enjoy everything that Bremen has to offer. Bremen recently constructed a nice area for families and visitors to have a picnic and hang out and sit there and watch the trains come in. So that's a nice place just to go and get a little bit of sun and enjoy some of that stuff. So I definitely consider Bremen a small town, but it is big enough for your conveniences. So if you are familiar at all with the West Georgia area, you know we are very accustomed to rural areas. But Bremen is a step up for most of our community since it has a Walmart and several fast food chains. So if you're in some of the other smaller towns like Tallapoosa, Buckhannon, some of those, you don't have access to that. And Bremen is where you would come to. Even going all the way through I-20 and into Alabama, a lot of those people are going to come to the Bremen Walmart smart because it's just the closest convenience that we have around. But Bremen is obviously small, so it gives off that friendly small town vibe where people love to jump in, help out, give a helping hand, whatever they can. The locals, you know, go and have breakfast at the same spot every day and know everybody. Now, Bremen is not big enough to have like a big name sit down restaurant, unless you count Cracker Barrel, which I totally do. But it does have a couple of local eateries that you can go and sit down and have dinner with your family if you're not wanting to grab fast food. Bremen is slightly cheaper than average. So Georgia as a whole is a cheaper state compared to other states in America. It ranks at 93.4, but Bremen comes in below it and its neighboring city, Carrollton, at 91.2. So this is the perfect location if you're looking to maybe work in Atlanta, but you don't want to pay the expensive housing and things like that. Like, they come to Bremen because we're right off of the interstate and it's a really quick location, which is my next big pro. Location, location, location. Bremen is centrally located to everything. We are literally right beside the interstate. So it's a really quick commute to get down I-20 into Alabama or Georgia, wherever you're wanting to go. It's feasible to live in Bremen and make that track. So Bremen is 46 miles from Atlanta. So depending on traffic, you know, our rush hour traffic in Atlanta is really bad in the mornings, but depending on when you go, you can very easily get there in an hour, which is a really good deal. And then if you wanted to go to not quite Atlanta, but a bigger city like Douglasville, is still really close and you can live in a more rural area like Bremen, but still make that drive, which is great. And I think that's one of the like most unique things about Bremen is it is so close to I-20, but it still feels like a remote small town. Bremen also has really good Wi-Fi options and cell phone service, especially considering how rural we are. There are several providers, which is really hard to find in some of your smaller towns like in Tallapoosa and things like that. But it is more rural, but you still get all of those options and you have really good cell phone service. Now, if you're going outside of Bremen, you're going more into the Harrelson County, not quite as good. But if you're inside of Bremen, those are still really great. Now, one of the biggest cons that most people probably do not know about is Bremen actually has a high crime rate. If you are looking at other cities in the state of Georgia that are the same size and have the same rural aspect that Bremen does, Bremen's crime rate is more. So theirs is 58 per 1,000 people. So, you know, we don't have like vandals and crazy things like that. I personally believe it's because we're so close to the interstate, and you will see the Bremen City cops sitting right there on the interstate and pulling people over, and that gets pulled into our traffic numbers is what I think, because you see them all the time writing tickets and getting people for who knows what. So I can only imagine what all crimes is associated because of being that close to the interstate. Another con that you should think of if you're moving to Bremen or any of the West Georgia areas is the weather. During the summer months, the heat is insane. Once May gets here, it gets super warm, super fast, and then the humidity is right on its tail. I keep my hair in a ponytail basically all summer because it's just unbearable. But the good part of this is we don't have these unbearable winters. The winters don't get crazy cold. I mean, to me, I get pretty cold, but I know a lot of Northerners that are like, this is nothing, and they're still wearing shorts. So I take that as we don't have crazy cold winters, unless you're, you know, a weenie like me and I get cold. We do have a really bad pollen problem. So if you have allergies, this is something to really think about, because when spring rolls in, you can literally see sheets of yellow blowing by because the pollen is so bad. And if you do have those allergies, you better go ahead and stock up on some Sudafed right now because it gets bad. I know some people, it doesn't affect them at all, but I'm one of those that it definitely affects me. So that's a pretty bad con for me. Also, Bremen city taxes are pretty expensive. So if you're living in Bremen, you have to pay the city and the county tax. One of the houses that I own is a cheaper home. Like, I bought it for $70,000 and the taxes on it's almost $3,000. You do pay a lot in taxes, but you're paying for that Bremen city education. And I know people that will do anything to pay and get into Bremen, so they're willing to pay the taxes. Now, if you are older, you can apply for an exemption. You can also look at homestead exemption that will help you a little bit, but that is something to definitely consider. Houses in the city limit are more difficult to find. And if you do find one, it's typically going to cost you more money than something just in Harrelson County. So the difference of a few feet that would be Bremen City and what falls into Harrelson County, there's a hefty price tag that comes with that. Again, because of the school system. I cannot stress to you guys how much everybody loves these school systems. They want their kids in there, so they're willing to pay more to get to that house. And it's hard to find that affordable housing in there. You can find several that are in the upper 200s and 300s, but finding something that, you know, is upper 100s can be pretty difficult, and you have to be ready to jump on it. Now, there is an option if you found a home that you absolutely loved and it's in Harrelson County but not in Bremen City. The city will let you pay tuition for your child to go there if you don't live in the city limits. So that is an option that you could look into if you wanted to have your child go there, but you cannot find a home exactly in the city limits. As promised, I'm going to give you the list of schools, give you a rundown on what's going to be the best. If you found this video helpful, if you would, just give me a thumbs up. That lets me know it was good, useful information so I can make more of them. So if we're looking at school system, Bremen by far outweighs everyone in our area. Like even by a long shot, all the way up to Atlanta, Bremen is definitely ahead of that pack. So on the top schools in Georgia, Bremen comes in at number 5. Now, if you're looking to go a little bit outside of that, you can look at Carrollton City Schools. Carrollton City Schools ranks at number 14 on this list. And then if you go a little bit wider and you cover Carroll County Schools, they come in at 26. Right here in this little bitty mile radius, you've got 3 schools that are top 30 that would make a really good option to pick from if you couldn't quite get into Bremen or you wanted to open your options and see. As always, check out the guide below that's going to give you all the information you need on moving. Thanks for watching. I'm your unicorn real estate agent, turning your real estate dreams into a reality.